हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ क्वांटिटी सर्विंग एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स मैनेजमेंट। दिस इज प्रोफेसर विद्यासागर मूगी। इन दिस सेशन वील बी स्टडिंग अबाउट अ कंसेप्ट कॉल्ड एज इंजीनियरिंग प्रोक्योरमेंट एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन, इन शॉर्ट कॉल्ड एज ईपीसी। नाउ व्हाट इज दिस ईपीसी? सो ईपीसी इज अ पर्टिकुलर फॉर्म ऑफ contracting arrangement used in some industries where the EPC contractor is made responsible for all the activities from design, procurement, construction to commissioning and handover of the project to the end user or owner, right? So EPC or engineering, procurement and construction is taken up by one particular individuals or a organization which is called as EPC contractor, where that particular individual or organization carries out, starting from design, procurement, construction to handing over of the project for a ready use to the end user or the owner. Now in this, the engineering and construction contractor, what he does is he'll carry out the detailed engineering design of the project, procure all the equipments and materials that are necessary, and then construct to deliver a functioning facility or asset to their client. So EPC contract mostly used in infrastructure and construction industries, thermal power plants, projects, etc. Even though this EPC module is a contract management module, it is very much required to understand by the person who is handling the finance and accounting for those contract, because its typical nature of contract compares the other contract module. Because it is said that he is a single point of contact, so all the responsibilities and risks are taken by that individual person or organization. So EPC contract will carry out the detailed engineering designs of the project. So means complete work starting of design to the finishing stage. Now, what are these? There are some features of a EPC contract that we'll discuss here. So, first feature is called as the single point responsibility. What happens here is, in single point responsibility, the EPC contractor will be the single point responsibility for all the contract works and transactions to the client. So, commonly the EPC contractor will subcontract the part works with the other contractors. However, the EPC contractor only will be the single point responsibility to the client for the work of subcontractors also. Now, in this single point responsibility, this EPC contractor will be the single point of contact with the owner. This EPC contractor can give again subcontracts. But when it comes to taking risks and responsibilities, EPC contractor will be the single point contact with the owner. So EPC contractor takes all the risks, contingencies and other circumstances which may influence or affect the work by signing the contract. Contractor accepts total responsibility for having foreseen all the difficulties and costs of successfully completing the works. So single point responsibility is what the EPC contractor, one of the features is, he takes the responsibility single-handedly. The next, milestone basis program. So milestone basis program, here since the EPC contract is involving the end to end contract arrangement, generally the works of the EPC contractor will be measured by milestone basis. So here how it is, like if I take an example of a building, so I'll say that milestone in the sense that when the work is completed up to plinth level. Now if I say this is the footing, so the building is like this. Now suppose a contractor completes the plinth level work, so that means he has achieved one milestone. They'll be setting the milestone that if I complete up till plinth level, that is my first milestone, then up to slab level, that will be second milestone, then up to next slab, that will be third milestone, and so on. And depending upon the progress of work, the EPC contractor will be setting a milestone based on which the client will be paying him the amount. So here the total contract activities will be segregated into a various set of activities, and the activities will be linked to a multiplier milestone. That is what I told. Each activity will be linked to particular milestone. That is, from excavation to plinth is one milestone. So from plinth to first slab is the second milestone, and so on. Then in this, the EPC contractor billing will be done based on the milestone that he achieves. So billing will be based on the milestone or milestone completion basis. So that is the second feature, that is milestone basis progress. Third one is prescribed time limit. So in this, the EPC contractor will be strictly following with the prescribed time limit for overall contract as well as each activity. So initially, while the time of contracting, the EPC contractor will be agreeing to the timely completion of the activities based on which he has to fulfill the client's demand of handing over the project at a particular scheduled time. So here in this, what happens is the contractor's responsibility is to complete the activity within the timeline given to him for each activity. So here it also requires that the contractor has to complete the activity and raise the bill to the client for getting the payment for their financial requirement. So initially they'll be setting up the terms saying that, so I'll be releasing the amount based on the timely completion of the work. So up till you complete the work up till one stage, so I'll release the amount for the next stage. So because of that, the contractor has to strictly adhere to the time and he has to complete all the activities within the time limit. Here one more thing is, the contractor, if he fails to meet the time limit, then he may even face the liquidity damage and deduction from their payments. So here he has to be very much particular about the time, or he may face liquidity damage and payment deduction. Then the next feature is fixed payment terms. So in EPC contracts, the contractor payment terms are very specific and fixed. The payment term always is linked to the milestone performance of the contractor. And also having some kind of retention on bill payment till the contractor executes the work perfectly. So the client may also retain some of the payment, retain amount, so as to get work done perfectly. done perfectly. So now moving on to next. So high degree of control. So for client perspective, they will have a very high degree of control over the project since single point of responsibility. So since EPC contractor is the only single point of responsibility, so client will be having very high degree of control over the project. But cannot be treated as an absolute control in point of contractor perspective. In the same hand, the contractor doesn't have the complete control over the project, because even though the EPC contractor, most of the contracts having some activities need to be completed by the client side. So even though EPC contractor is given the responsibility to complete the project, there are some particular things which should be taken care from the client side. So what are those things that should be taken care by the client side? Are like the clearance required for the legal execution of the project, legal documents, that is the clearance from the government departments, then any other permissions, NOCs, all these things should be taken care by whom? It should be taken care from the client side. So that are permissions and non-objection certificates. So all these things are taken care by the client side. Next feature is free from cost variation. So free from cost variation here, unless it is mentioned in the contract, all EPC contracts are free from price variation. They are free from price variation. That is, when at the time of agreement between the client and the contractor, so both the people or both the organizations come into conclusion or agreement based on the price that are being fixed between both. May it be the labor price, material price, or whatever, all the costs that are involved for the civil engineering construction. So in the contract, unless it is mentioned specially, then all the contracts are free from what? Price variation. But the client will offer the contract at the fixed price, and that is committed price by both the contractor and client. The cost which agreed is free from the market price variation. Hence, the EPC contractor is very much careful at the time of fixation of the price, because the price commitment is done at the prior stage. So EPC contractor must be aware of price before fixation or giving the commitment, because he cannot make a loss for himself by randomly fixing the amount without having any knowledge of the field. So you must be very much aware. Then next, limited risk for client. So here, EPC contractor gives the maximum optimized risk to the client, because most of the EPC contracts are offered by the client based on the performance bank guarantee by the EPC contractor. So there itself, the risk of the client will be reduced to the maximum extent. And also the contract terms will be very specific with the contractor's scope of work, roles and responsibilities of the contractor, which is linked to the financial terms. Also, non-performance of the contractor will affect the contractor himself and then the client at the last. So the client is free from risk, or he is having minimum risk. Because once the contract is done, so responsibilities of the EPC contractor to carry out the work. So if he happens to be negligent or the performance is not up to the mark, then it is the contractor who is going to get affected first. Then affected will be the client. So these are the features of the EPC contractors, and I hope you know what is EPC contractors now. Thank you very much.